Give us a little synopsis of the of football in Dominica for the year gone by.
Well, generally, our football is still going on now. Our Premier League is in, you can say, past the midway stage. It's doing very success in terms of the competitiveness. It's not a clear-cut runaway for any team. As we speak, the champion team, Dubla, just won on Saturday gone. So they are closer to the championship, but it's not all gone for them in terms of winning the championship. They might have some other games to play. Our Division 1 league have also started. So we have two competitions going on now, which is the Premier and the Division 1. We expect to start the Women's League, our senior women's competition, in January. And what we expect, what we want to do is have some youth programs, you know what I mean, youth programs under 15, under 17, or under 20. But basically, that's where we are in terms of football in Dominica.
And in terms of the whole development of football in Dominica, how satisfied are you with the level of play that is currently ongoing in terms of football at the under 15, at the under 20, at all the levels?
Well, it's too early to talk about the under 15s. But at the senior level, I believe there's a lot of room for improvement. I always compare the past than what's happening now, because I'm in the football I played, and together with your president, the standard was much higher. We played more because of the love of football. Now there's more competitiveness, things around us that might deter us in terms of the competitiveness we have now. But that shouldn't be the reason. I believe that if we want to develop football and if you want to play football, I think the goal is on the players, because it's about the players. Without, yes, you need the administration personnel, but without the footballers or without the players, there's no football. Even President Cheney mentioned in the past that we train twice a day before. You know, we get up in the morning at 5 o'clock and have two training sessions. So I believe it's something that we all have to work on, I think, within the region, and see how best we can bring these glory days back. It's going to be challenging. It's not going to be easy. I think the direction of this is going down to the youth programs, the grassroots, the under 15, the under 13. So we can identify talent from a very, very early age, and that in itself will help our growth of football in the future.
And on that note, what are the plans, or what are some of the structures being put in place to ensure the continued development of football in Dominica?
Well, the structures, I have in my head or plan to do, is having an elite academy of youth ages. At an early age, we're going to compete with the under 15 CONCACAF, which is going to be in 2017. So when our under 15 teams get back to Dominica, it's keeping them in a regular training camp. So these under 15 players will eventually turn to under 17, will eventually go to the under 19s and to the senior players. Because football itself is a real revolutionary sport. So some players might fall out of the crack, but most of them, if you can identify them at a very early age, I believe it's going to utter well for Dominican football, or whether in the region. And that is one of the way to go, is keeping the players at an early stage. What I've noticed also, I don't know if Grenada has it, we have a number of academies in Dominica. They need to be restructured, you know, because that's where maybe you need your better coaches. Some people might think you need your top coach at the top. No, you need your better coaches at the beginning, start of it, at the academies, because that's where the basics are being taught. And if you are learning the wrong basics of football or any sport, as a matter of fact, then it's just going to be a nightmare for you going forward.
What are the plans of the Windward Islands Football Association to get those young persons involved in football and to develop the whole Windward Islands football in general?
Well, like I said before, is getting to play more competition. You know, I mean, if you look at the North Americans and the Mexicos and them, they've played a number of competition. You know, so for us to compete with them, we need to play more football regular. So that is one of the reasons of the Windward Island tournament. Apart from maybe just playing the CFU tournament every 2 years, you need to have, you know, outside of that, other competition that you can engage with. We have started, like I said, the men and women's senior. But what we need to do is to establish youth tournaments within the Windward Island tournament, under 15, under 17, and under 20. So that itself will help motivate our players, you know, because then there'll be some other competition that they're going to be engaging. Because we only play sometimes within the region at the CFU level every 2 years. So then in the odd year, the Windward tournament is going to help the players, keep them active and keep them motivated. Yeah, thank you.